Hey filmmaker, Chung here. In this video, we're going to teach you how to make decorative swirls inside of Premiere Pro. So decorative swirls are like these swirls or decorations that you often see under like wedding titles, and just make them more like prettier and like a slightly more romantic feel to them. So we are going to make them inside of Premiere Pro. So the first thing we need is to make a color mat. Go to new items here, choose color mat, and we are going to press OK, and we can choose a color, but black is OK, it's here, and press OK. We're going to drag this onto the timeline, and we're going to right mouse click on it and press nest. The big reason why we want to nest this is because the right on effect that we are going to use somehow only works really good on a nested sequence. On any other generated like transparent or even like other kinds of effects or like layers or clips, it doesn't work that well than on a nested sequence. So press OK. We're going to effects, going to type in right in the search bar, and you will find under generate the right on effect. Drag this onto the nested sequence. Now we go to effects control, and here we are going to change a few parameters. We're going to change this to 001. This will make the lines much smoother. We're going to change the brush size to 10, so it's a much more visible line. So we can see this dot is basically the beginning of the line, and the rest should be fine here. So we're going to use the brush position to move the start here. So we're going to move it slightly off-centered so we can actually duplicate one on the other side, and we are going to, let's move the timeline from the start, and I'm going to hit this stopwatch to add a keyframe. So we're going to hold down shift and then arrow to the right to jump 5 frames, and we're going to do this quite a lot, and then we're basically going to change this point, move it around to make a line. So we're going to, so we're moving this over here, and if you notice there is like blue dots here, so we're going to zoom in a little bit and make this a little bit more visible so we can see these darker dots. These are basically the beziers, so we can move this around to make a curvature. So that is like a start. Let's change this. 250 should be a nice size here. So we're going to hold down shift again and now arrow to the right to jump to the next 5 frames. And again, we're just going to drag this to the next point. Find the bezier. Sometimes the bezier is a little bit hidden under this round circle, so you kind of need to search for it. And this bezier here, let's make this like a nice round shape here. Let's see that. Okay, and now shift arrow to the right again and move this and move the bezier so we can draw the shape better. And I think that should be fine like that. Okay, shift arrow to the right, move this, and this shouldn't be that far, and find this bezier. Okay, pretty much we have like the shape that we want, maybe less extreme here, or read the curve here nicer. So we can now just adjust the shape till we like it. I think this should be fine. So let's go to fit. So we have here the line basically. Now if we move the timeline and play it, we can see how it's being drawn. So this is like a nice drawn automated drawing of the swirl. So now to make the second one, or actually duplicate this. So we can't really just duplicate it and just mirror or just put it on the here next to it. So what we can do is go to effects and type in mirror. So mirror and use this. Drag to the next sequence and go to effects control. Here under it, this parameter need to just half it. So 2080 or 1280 for me. And now we have the two lines. So we play it and we see it being drawn like that. So one thing to notice, right now we are working on basically a black video. If I just draw this blue column at under here, or put this on top and move this, so now we can't see the blue color mat. So we need to go into effects control. We can change the paint style here. So instead of being on the original image making it black, we can make it transparent. So now we can see actually the image behind it, or we can even make it reveal the original image to make it black. So that was mainly it, how to make a decorative swirl inside of Premiere Pro. Hope you guys found this a very interesting video. If you want to see more upcoming videos, please hit that subscribe button here below. Also make sure to hit that bell icon so you're always updated when I post a new video. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you the next time. Bye bye.